I dare you to play footsie with me throughout this whole interview. Hey.
I can do that.
Hey. Do a souls match?
And not even smile.
Go ahead. I'm not gonna smile, but I will make this face.
All pie is good pie.
There's a level of detail in the movie that is so specifically actually Gary Johnson. Whenever somebody would come up and he would say, I'm going to be the guy you asked me, you know, how do you like your pie? And I'll say, all pie is good pie. That's really Gary Johnson.
I think what the fun part about, you know, studying to try to play Gary was, is like really looking at everybody in my life differently, being like, oh, could they be a hitman? Could they be, you know what I mean? And like, you do look at friends of yours, and you're like, okay, like that guy's a hitman.
I find that to be my favorite part of pre-production is you study people in a different way. You kind of take in the world in a different way. It's fun. It's just, it's all human behavior. And this is why Richard Linklater is the perfect person to direct this movie. He is like, he's a psychologist. He's a philosopher. He's really thinking about these things all the time. And he's like such an honest filmmaker that I feel like once you kind of go into like genre, I feel like you start playing into tropes. He's like, let's not live in movie land. Like, what would actually happen? And that was always something I really learned from Rick, is I'm a big fan of movies. He's a big fan of movies. We watch a lot of movies together. But he never wanted things to feel dirty. Oh, you're good.
Sorry.
Oh, you're good. Sorry, that's just glue on my nipple.
Another day in the neighborhood.
Every actor pretends like they can do everything, but deep down inside, you're aware that, like, you can't. Like, you can try to do as much as you possibly can, but your job is to push yourself. But then there are also like limits to what is believable or viable or what an audience will accept, and you have to kind of like have enough self-awareness to know where that line is. I find that like fewer takes actually is more merciful in the longer run to get a better product. Sometimes knowing that you only have three shots, that, you know, three bites at the apple, makes you sharper. It also conserves energy over the course of the day and conserves the crew's energy. Everybody else is on point. People aren't tired and making mistakes in other places. So it's like really about crew morale too.
Oh, I'm really excited for people to see all the different characters that this man plays and his amazing ability as an actor. Not that they haven't seen it already.
Now I'm in my own head about it all.
No, I think just in this movie. You're amazing.
A lot to think about tonight.
So I've never written a crime story before, you know, anything that had thrilling elements or that sort of stuff. So like that was kind of a first for me. So Rick's not really that guy either. Like, he's not really a plot driven kind of filmmaker. He's more character driven. So we really had to like put ourselves in the audience's shoes, because the type of audience that, you know, loves those movies, they're very smart. They consume them like crazy. So you want to create a simple enough story that it's more about the character, but also a compelling enough story where people are actually leaning in. He's a fantasy to her and she's a fantasy to him. There's a lot of points in the story where like she's ahead of Gary, and there's points in the story where, you know, you always have, you know, somebody who's unaware that she's unaware that he's Gary Johnson. And then there are points in the movie where he's very unaware of her motives and what she's asking and why she's asking and those sort of things.
I think this movie is the kitchen sink of every fun thing you go to the movies for.
He's sexy.
Thrilling.
Really sexy.
Mysterious.
And sexiest.
And funny.
And also funny sexy.
Oh, good God.
Dive deeper into the Netflix shows and films you love on todoom.com.